Day came face to face with heroes right out of their history books. The Black History Month event honored World War II Tuskegee Airmen. CBS 2's Jennifer McLogan reports from Bright Waters, where the students were awestruck.
Knowing that you can see them in real life right in front of you, it's a cool thing. It's a cool experience.
The treat of learning from real Tuskegee Airmen, survivors of World War II, survivors of harsh racial segregation, is a life lesson for the children of Gardner Manor Elementary in Brightwaters.
Were you scared for the warfare?
Well into their 90s, with numbers diminishing every day, the Tuskegee Airmen are honored as the first African-American military aviators in U.S. Armed Forces history. Until First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt became involved in the cause, blacks had been banned from piloting wartime planes.
This is history right here. This is a copy telling us that the black brain is not capable
of being taught how to fly a plane.
Dabney Montgomery helped change history in Italy, bombing the Nazis with his all-black squadron. Trained in Tuskegee, Alabama, the fighter pilot military units remain separate from whites, both at home and abroad.
White enlisted personnel didn't necessarily salute the officers, our black officers.
The salute finally came from the White House 62 years later.
In 2007, the Tuskegee Airmen were collectively awarded the Congressional Gold Medal at a ceremony in the U.S. Capitol Rotunda.
You said you wasn't saluted during the World War II, but I salute you now.
And we all salute you now, sir.
It's very nice meeting a real hero.
From Brightwaters, Long Island, Jennifer McLogan, CBS 2 News.
The ceremony, scheduled for just an hour, lasted all day because the children were so caught up in the history and meeting those heroes. For more on Black History Month, including a list of events, visit CBSNewYork.com.